Lewis. Welcome to Brew Talking TV, brand new channel I'm starting. We're going to be talking about different reviews on beers, wine, spirits, a bit of home brewing, talking about different breweries, the artwork on the bottles. You know, it's not all about the taste. Sometimes it's about the artwork on the bottles as well. So we're going to be getting into all that over the series. And as I said, home brewing. At the moment, I've got a red wine and a white wine upstairs fermenting as we speak. Once it's bottled and ready, I'll do a review on that, and then when I come to do the next batch, we'll do a quick sort of review on that. Well, I don't want to go too much into the process of home brewing. There are loads of other people doing that. I'm not going to drop any names just yet, but yeah. So first of all, today's first review is on one of my favourite ales, Fursty Ferret. So first of all, we're going to just talk about the artwork. Okay, so this is Fursty Ferret by Badger Brewery. I believe they're a part of Hall and Woodhouse in Somerset. This is brewed in Dorset. If we look at the bottle straight away, obviously it's quite funny. Fursty Ferret, you put your ferret in your barrel. It is a nice piece of artwork on the bottle. You know, I quite like it. It does draw your eye. That's why I first got it. When I pick ales, if it's got a funny name, I'll give it a go. As I said, Badger Brewery, yeah, they do some good products. On the back of the bottle, we've got all the information, how many units, and it actually gives us tasting notes. We've got, you know, what it looks like, what it smells like, what it tastes like. I'm not going to read theirs, I'll give you my own. And as we can see, yeah, you know, it's a nice looking bottle. What more do you want? We've had a nice close up on it, you can all see that. Here's the back, there's the cap on the top. Can we see that? Hopefully we can. I think enough talking about the bottle. We need to crack this open and we'll pour it and get a drink going. Okay, so we're going to crack it open, and as soon as you open it, it has got that definite ale smell about it. It's quite delicate. You can smell the hops and the malt. It has actually got, there's a slight note of orange behind it, which is not unpleasant. Colour wise, as you can see, it's not too dark. It's not a pale sort of ale by any chance. It pours quite nicely. One thing that does wind me up, you never get the whole out of the bottle. Anyway, yeah, it does form quite a nice head on it. It's not too carbonated, which is nice, you know, when you're drinking it out. I don't want it to be too fizzy. That's for lager, in my opinion. Others might differ, but it's not like your bitters and the lagers where you've got a sort of thick, creamy head, like Guinness and stuff like that. It is going to settle down straight away. Taste of it. It's quite a potent taste to it, considering it's not, in my opinion, very dark. It tastes good, you know, it's got a very crisp taste to it. You can taste the hops and the malt in it, and you can actually taste that orange I was talking about. But on the back of the bottle it says, malty sweet, bitter balance. Yeah, I'd agree with that. You can taste the orange in it. Not gonna lie to you. It's I don't have it too warm when I have ale, or too cold, you know. It's not ice cold, like you'd have lager or something. It's chilled, it's been out of the fridge. Put it in the fridge a couple of hours and I leave it out for about 10 minutes just to warm up slightly. It's good. Yeah, I like it. Go well with some barbecue, you know, come home from work, have a bottle of Fursty Ferret. Well worth trying it. I believe you can order it. Search Badger Breweries or search Hall and Woodhouse. Even check, I mean, I bought this from a supermarket. It's nothing special. It's not, you know, like a one-off brew or anything like that. You can buy it in supermarkets, but it is nice. It's worth trying. Go out and get yourself some. I'm going to finish this, and I'll catch up with you in the next video. Hope you enjoyed.